Hello everyone, this is Jay from Video Shelter. So today we are going to discuss three different techniques to remove the background in Photoshop. This is going to be a very basic and beginner tutorial and kind of intermediate as well, because we are going to use channels as well to remove the background. So yeah, this is the image. We'll start with image. This image number one. And I've got this one girl with crazy hair and this yoga teacher. I don't know, I'll be just cutting this out. So let's start with sand dunes. This is going to be a very basic kind of a selection. If you are a bit familiar with Photoshop, so you'll be knowing about the tool called quick selection tool. So quick selection tool, I'll give you a brief about it once. So this is a selection tool. You can select anything, you know, with the help of this brush, which you can grow by close bracket and open bracket. These are the other two, three options for the quick selection tool. When you see the plus is activated, it means you can add on the selection. When minus is activated, you can just delete the selection. There's a shortcut for minus as well, which I'll be telling you in just quite some time. Alright, so let's get started. So I'll choose the plus thing. You know, quick selection tool is good when you have a kind of image which is not merging with the background. If you see closely to this image, I just zoom in. You can see the blue color of the sky and the brownish color of the sand is like not at all matching with each other. So there's a huge difference between the color, and we can see the outline going around. So it's very easy for quick selection tool to calculate the color and select what we are selecting. So we'll just hold and drag till the time we can drag till end. Yeah, look, we got the proper selection. We can add this, obviously. Yeah. So you can always increase your brush size, which will help you to select the larger area in one go. So yeah, it's quite decent selection here. If you see, there's no here and there. There's quite some here which I can see. I'll just tell you in a moment how this works. So I'll just go zoom in, I'll decrease the size of my brush, I'll hold on my Alt key, this is the shortcut for the minus this selection tool here. So hold on the Alt, I'll decrease the size a bit more, zoom in a bit more, hold on the Alt and try to get in as close as possible. You have to be very particular though, it gone. So I'll be leaving my Alt tool, it's again an add, so I'll just click here. So it's overall a very good selection. I'm pretty much happy with the selection right now, so I'll go back. So what you can do is you can just press the delete key on your keyboard and the background is gone. Control D for deselect. I just want to put a different sky over here, so I have already selected the sky. This is this. So I'll activate my move tool. Either you can go here or you can press V key on your keyboard and you'll get the move tool. So you can click and hold and drag it to the different document where we are working. Come in the center and let go. So your background is here, you just have to align it wherever you feel like. I think it's pretty good. As you know, the layer above will be shown first. So what we'll do is we'll just hold and drag it below the main layer. Yes, there's a different sky. So what we can do is we can just move the sky a bit more so we can see, we can have this parallax kind of a thing here going on. This is pretty cool, I guess. So yeah, I can go a bit more high. Nah, it's perfectly fine. Yeah, it's good. So this is one way you can definitely remove your background. But quick selection tool is not always handy. So when you get something like this, so this is really very tough. You know. So quick selection tool is used when you can see clear difference between two things which you have to exclude from each other. So quick selection tool is very handy in that case. So, but if you have to go and select this kind of a messy scene, when you get, you know, most of the retouchers get these kind of shots. So they have to delete each and every, you know, curve of the hair, and they have to be very precise about the selections and everything. So it's going to be very hard. If you try with this quick selection tool, if you do this, let's unlock the layer. When you double click on this thing, they unlock the layer. Sorry. So if you select this, you can still see. If I zoom in, it's going over the hair, so it's going to be very messy thing. So it's very hard for you to go keep on going and selecting and deselecting thing. It's very painful. So what we will do is we'll use a different technique over here, which is called channel technique. So channel layer you can find in the layers panel over here. So I'll give you a brief introduction about the channels, right? So as you know, we are working in Photoshop. So Photoshop is basically a pixel based software. So we'll be using this RGB color code. So RGB means red, green and blue. So if we red, green and blue combines together and make RGB, and we get this kind of image, which is in our layer panel, right? So let's go to channel. I'll show you one by one. I'll select the red color. This is just showing the red channels of the image. I'll select the green color, just showing the green colors of the image, and the blue channels. It's going to be seen. So we have to find the most contrasty channel. According to me, blue is the most contrasty channel. You can see a huge difference. So what we have to do, we cannot work on the same channel. We have to copy it. Otherwise, if I make any kind of adjustments in clear color here, let's say this, and if you go to our layer channel and select all these layers, so we'll have a different look, because we are messing around with the main channel. So we don't have to do that. What we have to do is, I'll just control C and click back. So I'll just click and drag the layer over this layer, and I've created a new copy, so we can mess with this thing. All right, we can mess. So I'll just go to the image adjustments levels. So there's a shortcut as well, Control L or Command L if you want Mac. So I'll just crank in more contrast. So this number totally varies from image to image, alright? I don't know what kind of image you must be using and what kind of color channels you are having in that thing. So it entirely depends on your image. So you have to go back and forth and see which kind of contrast is fitting. I guess this is pretty good. I'm pretty much happy with this thing. This look okay. So what we have to do is, we have to click Control. And when you click Control on your keyboard, hold Control, sorry. So you get a checkbox when you do that. It means we are going to select that. So hold the control and click on your blue channel copy, and we have selected the entire thing. Alright, so let's go to the layers channel. We will add a mask on here, and we have got the selection, but we want to inverse the selection, so we'll do Control I, Command I on Mac, so get to inverse the selection, right? So we can see, if I hold the Alt and press the mask icon here, you have to click Alt and press the mask icon, it will come back. If you control or hold Alt and click the mask icon, it will go back. It's easier to work like this, because the black channel, you won't see anything. The white color here is visible, it will be 100% visible. The transparency in between, it means it's in between, it will be, you know, opaque, you can see through it, but we don't want that. We want the entire image of the girl. So what we will do is, we'll select the brush tool here. The shortcut for brush tool is P on your keyboard, or you can go select the brush tool. So I'll try to keep the hardness somewhere around, hardness of the brush somewhere around 70. Size varies, like whenever you try to do that, size entirely depends how closely and how minutely detailing you are doing. So as you see, my foreground and background colors are selected. White color means the things are coming back, we are getting the girl's entire face back, which was opaque. So we'll just hold and drag, and here we get the entire girl back. Alright, you just have to be very particular what you want and what you don't. So I just decrease this, feather it out a bit, so I can get this minute detail. Let me just zoom in, Control plus to zoom in, Control minus to zoom out. So I'll close bracket to decrease the size of my brush. Holding down the space bar and moving the screen, you can move your entire document. I don't know. These are the basics. So it's looking pretty fine with me here. And we can some more hair from here. So yeah, I'm not going too far, I'm not going too hard on it. Just my alright. Now what we have to do is, if you see close, very close, if you can see this, you know, different patches of color, white color, it means there is something which is visible right now, but we want to completely remove the background. So I'll switch the colors. Black is now activated, it means we'll be deleting the things which are here. So I'll just increase the size, open bracket again, just drag, block, it's gone. I'll make my brush a bit more feathery, so we can go minutely in this thing. Decrease the size, zoom in again, hold my space bar to move the document. It's looking good. You can't see here much, but yeah, you can just try, go back and just see. If you want to go back and see, you just hold the alt button and click on the mask. You'll see, look how detailed. It's so detailed. It's very easy, it's way much better than using the pen tool or quick selection tool to select each and every detailing of hair from here, so which is quite painful. So this is the technique I mostly use to remove the complex background like this one, right? So I won't be going much in detail, so you got the idea how to do it. So I'll just hold on my alt and click on the mask, I'll get the curl back. It's looking pretty good, so we should add some background here. I've just downloaded the background. Yeah. It's kind of weird, but yeah, this is what I like. Control T. Hold your shift and alt button so you can increase the size of your image in proportion. Right? Again, you have to drag it down. So if you zoom in now closely, you can see the detail is there. How easily. These are the things which you really need to work on when you switch between brushes, black to white and black to white. Alright. So this is just a basic idea you must have, you know. The more effort and more time you put in, the more better quality you have. I have to finish this tutorial. So I'm in like a rush. So this is the second technique, channel technique. We have learned two techniques. One is quick selection tool, other is playing with the channels here in the layer panel. Now this is the best technique to remove any object and place it on a different object, different image you can say. So pen tool, this is the heart and soul of selection in any designing software, whether it's Adobe Illustrator, Corel Draw, Photoshop. Pen tool is must. I'll tell you why pen tool is great, because making selections, complex selections like these, curves and everything from here to here, pen tool is the best tool to use. I'll just give you brief, then I'll just forward the video very quickly to completely select this girl doing a yoga pose here, looking very beautiful. Alright, so let's start. So there are two basics of using pen tool. You just have to be very, you just need to zoom in to your image. Let's start with the back. So let's click here. I think this is fine. We can click here without letting go the mouse, your right left click. You just have to drag on the handles. If you see this, you can see bend outwards, bend inwards, so you can get a proper curve here of a body to make a very particular selection. Now if you want to point on create a new point here, you can either click here. That's your luck if you don't get a weird selection here, but I always like to hold alt and click on my this last point and check it from the pen tool to detach this thing. So yeah, so I'll be moving forward. I'll be selecting this again, alt to detach that thing, again alt and click, moving the handles like this. So you don't have to watch me doing all this. I'll be right back. right. When you come back and you're just about to connect your two ends, just click here and it's completed. You just have to click, make a right click in the center and click mix selection. 1.5 pixel is fine, I guess. Go back. You have to take your disk selection on a different layer, so you will hold on control or command if you're on Mac and press J. So your selection is on a different layer right now. Oh yeah, we just skipped this one, so I'll just quickly do that by selecting the layer. We'll do the same thing again. Right click, make selection, 0.5% feather, delete, control D to deselect. So what we will do is we'll just paste this picture on a different background. So we'll just press the move key, select it, drag it on a different document, which is this. I just leave it here. So you can see it's looking quite odd. Just press Ctrl T and increase the size of it. Take it here. Decrease a bit. So yeah. So for more better thing, we can control. We can keep Ctrl Shift N for a new layer. Create a selection tool. 30% pixels, you can select Ctrl T. Place it right here. Bring the layer below this thing. Opacity somewhere around 32, I guess. It's looking perfectly. So, yeah. So we have learned three different techniques today for removing the background. So yeah, if you see this picture closely, there are few things which are, you know, which can be done properly, but I've done very quickly for the sake of tutorial. But you guys are smart enough to get the idea, I guess. So I'll just go back and give you a brief again. So this was sand dunes. We have changed the background sky with the help of quick selection tool. Then we have this curly hair we have done with the help of channels and masks, alright. And then this yoga girl, which used to be like this, sorry, and we pasted it over here. So yeah, hope these three techniques were helpful for you, and if you like the video, do subscribe my channel. I need your support. Thank you so much, guys. Have a good night here from India.